We had a wonderful intro by our dear friend here. She was asking everything about what is 21 and what is CA cervix and all. How many of you all know that we need to get ourselves screened for cervical cancer? Yes, friends? Can I ask the press, how many of them know about why we need to do screening in India? Can I have any of my friends from the media answer me? Yes? No answer? One case of a coronavirus, and you want to put it as a headline, Corona has come to Hyderabad, as though we have won a Nobel Prize. What are we trying to put our Hyderabad on the top of the map? Friends, we have people dying of cervical cancer. By the time we finish this meeting, in an hour, 8 women would have actually lost their lives. If we had a bit of sensitivity to our women, I'm sure that women wouldn't be dying with cervical cancer. Look at the statistics. Look at where Norway is, a small country. And look at India, we are a powerhouse. We have Modi, Trump, all the relationships, but we have 96,922 cases annual incidents. And friends, 67,477 deaths annually. And that is the reason why we actually need to talk about screening for cervical cancer. We're talking about 21 women in Telangana. Don't you think it is the right of every woman in Telangana to see that she is being screened for cervical cancer? How many of you all have got a CA cervix screening done? Can you all raise your hands? I hardly see any hands which are being raised. So that itself shows that the knowledge we have about a disease which is killing. How many of you know about coronavirus? So that is what I think it's time that we ask our media friends to talk about the killer diseases which are actually taking the lives of women. More than a single virus which may actually die in the next few days because of whatever the reason. So friends, that is the reason. Look at what Globocon has told. The deaths in 2018, 60,078 deaths. That is the magnanimity of the cervical cancer. And there is a lot of human suffering because of cervical cancer. 1 in 4 women. And unfortunately, we are still leading in cervical cancer. And it is one of the most easily preventable cancers. Cervix is one structure which is very easily seen with the eyes of the healthcare provider, and it can be screened. You can detect it before it becomes an invasive cancer. And if you all look at how the Nobel Prizes are actually given, 2008 saw the Nobel Prize given to a gentleman because he just proved his point that this HPV vaccine or this HPV infection virus, this causes cervical cancer. And if we can vaccinate it, if you screen it, we can reduce the maternal mortality. Friends, that is the importance of cervical cancer. And when you look at the prevalence in India, Eastern India, Maharashtra, everywhere, even Telangana, unfortunately, we still have a very high prevalence. And that is attributing to the incidence of cancers. 8.6% of women, and unfortunately, more than 20% of the women are in India, and 2.2% in developed nations, compared to the 7.7% in the developing countries. Now, classification, there are so many types of viruses. We don't talk about all that. Only one simple coronavirus we keep talking. So I think it's time that we think how we can stop the cervical cancer, which is a killer disease killing our women. If you're talking about women empowerment, we're talking about no to violence against women. I think the first thing to do is to see how we screen all our women, how we vaccinate all our women, and understand that the persistent infection with the oncogenic HPV is a necessary cause of cervical cancer. And if we can detect it, if we can prevent it, I think nothing more needs to be offered to the women. And we know that this HPV 16, 18, there are so many strains, but 16 and 18 are the ones which are responsible for more than 70% of the cancers. And we know that this is causing all the changes which is happening in the cervix. We need not go into all that, those things which look like what is happening and how HPV is affecting the cervix. And when you summarize, we find that most people are infected with HPV. Some part of the life, usually it starts in the younger age group and more in the reproductive. By the time they reach a later part of the reproductive age, by then they reach the perimenopause, the incidence of infection reduces. So the adolescent girls and the young women, those who need to be vaccinated and those who need to be screened, are very important to reduce the burden of cervical cancer. And look at this 2030. Now, how many of you all know what 2030 stands for? SDG goals. At least I expected my gynec friends. The sustainable developmental goals. Unfortunately, we didn't meet up with the MDG goals 2015. So at least the world thought sustainable developmental goals is something which all the countries will actually try to strive for. And in that, we hope that 90% of all the girls would be vaccinated. 70% of the women would be screened for HPV tests. And that will reduce the mortality by 30%. Now, that is the significance of 2030. And that shows why we need to talk about screening. So friends, you have to understand with me that screening and prevention is very, very essential. We all have been talking about the pap smear. It's there from long before I became a doctor. And it's one of the very simple tests. And we have grown to where we know that the HPV DNA testing has come into vogue. So when you look at the screening, we have got the FOGSI GCPI. FOGSI is our organization, our federation, which we have 38,000 gynecologists in the whole country. And we have the head office in Mumbai. We have got 250 societies with all these members. And we have our guidelines. And we said that this HPV DNA test, which approved in 1999, above 30 years, but please do it. And in 2015, actually, the US FDA has given the go that the HPV test is the primary screening. Now, what are we doing? Always in India, we're very happy. Once the US FDA gives, then only we feel that, yes, we need to go around. And we need to do it. And more so the reason now when we know that causative reason is there, we can try to see. Even when you look at the global view, you need to do something which is very simple. Nobody would like to have an invasive test. HPV screening is a simple, non-invasive test. And that simple test, if we can offer to our women, I think what more you can do to your women. And definitely you have to understand that HPV DNA testing has shown to be superior to the simple cytology. The pap smear, which was actually introduced right very many years back. We have trained our A&Ms, we have trained our paramedical staff to take a pap smear. We have trained them how to see the cervix, how to see something abnormal and then refer. But then HPV DNA is much more simpler and easier. And that's what was reported by Margaret Stanley way back in 2010. So the primary testing as a standalone test should be the future, allow for a simplification of screening recommendations. So when you look at all the recommendations, let's not go into it. The recommendations say the WHO position statement and the advisory committee on the immunization practices both recommended that vaccination and HPV screening are very vital. And vaccination screening are the most realistic interventions for cervical cancer prevention in the long term. So friends, we have a simple test, this COBAL HPV test. Now, what is the importance of this test is, it is actually targeting the 16 and 18, which are responsible for the maximum number of serious cervix cases. So primary HPV screening will go a long way in preventing problems. And an appropriate response is actually have to be seen so that we would reach the sustainable developmental goals by 2030. Eradication of CA cervix and the HPV related disease is most vital and not a dream, much more important than the virus which we are worried about and what is going about in the WhatsApp and social media. So much. People have so much time. Why can't we talk about CA cervix and HPV prevention, which is killing the women over the globe and especially in our country? So vaccination is safe. Don't get worried. And so truly said Jawaharlal Nehru way back, we cannot allow tomorrow to slip out of our hands because of petty problems of today. So forget about the simple viruses which are there today, which may disappear tomorrow, and try to remove these viruses which are responsible for this deadly disease CA cervix. Friends, let's all join together. In my organization, I have 38,000 gynecologists. If each one screens 5 women per day, we would be screening about 1,90,000 women daily. And that would be, look at that figure. How many? It is going to close to 7 crores of women, and the population eligible for screening is also very high. So friends, together we can definitely eliminate cervical cancer if we decide that is our priority, and this is one of the core focus which will be in my agenda as a FOGSI president in 2021 next year. Friends, let's join together, and definitely we can do it if we think we can do it. Thank you very much.